Welcome to Walt Disney's Enchanted Tiki Room. Hey, Michael, mi amigo. Pay attention, it's Joe time.
Do you consider yourself a Disney fan? Perhaps a small-time collector? Maybe you have a few shelves full of memorabilia. Or maybe you've got a room dedicated to the stuff. But I guarantee you don't have enough to fill a former Sports Authority store. I didn't think you did. We're here in, We're here in Sherman Oaks, California to talk to the man who has one of the largest private collections of Disneyland memorabilia on Earth. We're here with collectors Richard and Nicholas Kraft. How are you doing?
Doing well, thank you.
Great.
Magical.
Oh.
You trying to one-up me already?
Yeah.
All right.
So Richard, you started off the collection, correct?
Yes.
When did you start?
I started 25 years ago. I had a brother, and we grew up in Bakersfield. We would go to Disneyland once a year when he was healthy because he had Crohn's disease. I heard there was going to be an auction of Disneyland attraction posters, so I bought one, the Autopia, and put it in my house as a remembrance of my brother. And then I got two, and then I got three, and then it's close to 1,000 items.
Is there anything that you may find yourself bidding on yourself just to keep it in the
family? You know, it's surprising. There's one weird piece that never mattered to me. It's a store figure of Snow White. We wrapped it up in newspaper, put it in a self-storage unit. We're baked, basically.
Yeah, we basically put it in an oven for 5 years.
Yes.
Slow cooked.
And when we unwrapped Snow White, she was a little distorted. So I was going to pull her from the auction because she's warped face Snow White, but now she's become my favorite item.
The internet rage is probably out there. There's probably so many people.
There's a lot of memes.
eBay.
There are people dressing up as her.
You've started a new internet phenomenon.
And
it's a very specific meme.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
You have to really be in the know.
Growing up as a kid, you were surrounded by crazy Disney memorabilia. What was that like?
Well, I thought what was always fun was bringing people to the house, because at some point it becomes the furniture in your home. In some ways, it was like, well, yes, there's a Mr. Toad car in the living room, but that's also where we sit and watch movies.
Yeah, so let's play Nintendo.
I beat Mario 64 sitting in that Astrojet. I remember beating Bowser sitting in an Astrojet.
And I've gotten to be sort of the mayor of That's from Disneyland, so I love giving spontaneous tours, and people are really emotional. I mean, I've had people sobbing looking at the Peter Pan ride because they remember, oh, I went on this with my mother who's not around anymore. A lot of parents showing, oh, that's a people mover, to their children, explaining their past.
You know, everyone has their own hometown, but Disneyland is a shared hometown.
Hello.
You're the guy, aren't you?
I am the guy for three more.
Your hand?
I'm the guy for three more days, then I'm a guy who used to own all this stuff.
Thank you for letting us see it.
Oh, I am enjoying sharing this more than you're going to enjoy seeing it. And I'm sorry about the line, but it's our tribute to Disneyland. What's an attraction without a line?
Richard's doing a really great job working the crowd. We're going to have to cut this part out because he's going to take
Are you a Mouseketeer?
He's going to take my job. What is the impetus of the auctions?
The impetus is, I have a four-year-old, who has special needs, and I'm an old dad, and I have to look out for her future. So it's like, oh, this could help take care of her way into the future. And she has this condition, Coffin-Siris syndrome, and it's like, oh, I can give some of these proceeds to the foundation for that. And she goes to a school, Chime. She doesn't care about owning Small World figures. She just wants to go to Small World.
You guys want to go take a look at some of your favorite
stuff? Sure.
This is not a car. This is a Global Van Line van. It says it right on the side.
I guess I should have known.
And it was a photo op on Main Street. Allegedly, Walt Disney drove this. It was his way of feeling like a common man. What are we looking at, Nikki?
This is one big D. It was from the Disneyland Hotel. From the side of the building, it had to be 16 feet tall.
The D that you see on Mulholland, there's a similar D that does not light up. It's John Stamos's. That's his house. And you can see his D from the highway, from the road. But my D is bigger.
When you own a canoe, then the best place to keep it is by water. So this was by our pool.
Yes, and it was a bit of a challenge because this is a really big canoe.
How does this work?
It doesn't.
Okay, good.
Because normally it'd be on a track with electricity.
Okay.
And we're in a Sports Authority building. But if it was the actual attraction, we'd sit in it, presumably very intoxicated. We start driving through town, hitting people. You end up getting hit by a train, and then you burn in hell where these devils mock you.
I want to thank Richard and Nicholas Kraft for having us up here to check out this awesome and extensive collection. If you guys want to check out the collection, August 25th, 26th, you can come on up here to Sherman Oaks and give it a shot. I want this ride, but I can't afford it, so I'm just going to kind of sit here until I can claim squatter's rights and it becomes mine.